The Philippine Agriculture Department launches a program to attract young Filipinos to go into agri-business. Now, Jackie Pascual tells us all about it in this report.
Eldrin Lee is not your typical farmer. This physics graduate has found success in urban farming by planting microgreens at a condominium unit in Manila. He's now distributing his harvest of cilantro, basil, arugula, and many more to various hotels and restaurants.
Wala tayong way para magtanim po dito sa Metro Manila. Ni-research po namin to para po makapag-grow po dito sa Metro. Everything depends sa agriculture. Kung hindi lang natin iniisip, pero pag may kinakain tayo, magsasaka po yung nagpapatubo niyan.
Former seaman Melvin Awid has also ventured into agriculture. Building on the knowledge he gained abroad, he started a vanilla farm in Sarangani province. He hopes to bring down the prices of vanilla extracts and cacao in the country.
Naisipan ko yung agribusiness, sir, when we were in Madagascar last 2019. So bilang isang seafarer po, I was able to meet a vanilla farmer in which naturuan po niya ako kung paano po yung cultivation sa vanilla planifolia.
Melvin and Eldrin are two of the almost 3,000 individuals who were given at least a 50,000 pesos grant under the Young Farmers Challenge program of the Department of Agriculture. The DA says the average age of farmers now is 57 years old, and many more are leaving the agriculture sector. This is why the agency hopes the program will attract young Filipinos to go into agribusiness and to elevate the industry as well.
Para ma-entice yung mga bata na magbalik ulit sa agrikultura by giving them startup capital. We help them in marketing and training to get their FDA certification.
18 to 30-year-old Filipinos can apply for the grant provided they have a good and clear business model that will potentially be profitable and benefit the agri sector.
You just need to give us an application letter which is a templated. You just need to give us a application form which is just only templated. And also a business model canvas. We don't need na magaling or anak ka ng farmer. Basta kakitaan lang namin sila, sir, ng passion about talaga sa agriculture.
About 600 individuals or groups will receive the grant this year. The products of Melvin, Eldrin, and others who were given the grant are on exhibit now at the Manila Foods and Beverages Expo in Pasay. If you want to know more, check the website agribusiness.da.gov.ph for details. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Now, a measure seeking to grant value-added tax refund to foreign tourists is gaining extensive support from multiple sectors. Sherian Torres reports.
A measure pushing for value-added tax refund for foreign tourists is getting widespread backing from various sectors. During Wednesday's hearing of the Senate Ways and Means Committee, representatives from the private sector and several government officials expressed support for the bill that will grant VAT refund to non-resident tourists who will purchase 3,000 pesos or over $50 worth of Philippine-made products.
We want to put emphasis sa mga local products natin, lalo na mga indigenous products natin. So, karamihan nito mga family-owned stores, no? So, gusto natin mas madali sa kanilang sumali dito sa prosesong to. Bumili siya ng item one time, eligible na siya for VAT refund. So, pwede niyang dalhin sa airport yung resibo at ibabalik sa kanya yung 12% na binayaran niya.
The Philippines is the only country in Southeast Asia that does not offer VAT refund to foreign tourists. Tourism Undersecretary Sharine Gail Yu Pamintuan says this somehow diminishes the interest of travelers to visit the Philippines. She adds the VAT refund program can help the Philippines reach its 2019 record of 8 million foreign tourists.
The added value of this measure because of the shopping tourism will just greatly contribute to, you know, reaching the 8.2 as well as to go beyond that number.
The Philippine Retailers Association, one of the groups supporting the VAT refund bill, says it will make the country a competitive shopping destination.
Singapore, Hong Kong have lost their luster already as a shopping destination. So where are they going? They're going to Thailand, they're going to even Indonesia or Malaysia. So it's about time that we not only be attractive, we must be competitive. And this will bring us to that competitive level.
According to Senator Gachalian, while government will lose 4 billion pesos in VAT collection due to the program, it stands to gain 9 billion pesos in revenues from the potential shopping activities of tourists. The senator estimates the VAT refund program can bring in an additional 140,000 foreign tourists per year and generate around 9,000 to 40,000 new jobs in the country. Gachalian also says the VAT refund system must be digital.
Digital na ngayon, pwede nang, for example, pag mumbili ka, pakita mo lang yung passport mo, i-scan yung passport mo. Pagdating mo sa airport, i-scan mo ulit, nandun na lahat ng binili mo. So, ang ibig sabihin, lahat ng resibo nakakabit na sa passport mo. Importante kasi yung OR dahil pag nagbayad yung tourist, binabayaran na yung gobyerno eh. Dahil yung OR, patunay yan na nagbayad ka na sa gobyerno.
The National Economic Development Authority says the proposed bill, once implemented, would boost government income from 2024 to 2028. NEDA explains the introduction of a VAT refund will lead to an additional 6 billion pesos to 9 billion pesos in overall tourist spending in the Philippines, since shopping is a big part of travelers' itineraries. Gachalian is set to endorse the VAT refund bill to the plenary with the required 8 signatures of panel members. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine lawmakers accused of brushing aside criticisms against the controversial Maharlika Investment Fund. Diwa Ginigundo, the central bank's former deputy governor, said a lot of economists had raised concerns over the controversial measure during congressional deliberations, but they were mostly ignored. He also casts doubt on the effectiveness of the sovereign wealth fund.
Whatever you take from the budget, okay, will have to be matched by higher taxes or higher borrowings. I don't know how the economic managers will be compensating whatever is going to be taken from the budget without increasing taxes or increasing the level of public debt.
The U.S. Federal Reserve presses the brakes on its rate hike cycle, as expected. But it says two more hikes could be coming later this year as inflation risks remain elevated. Data on Tuesday showed U.S. inflation cooled in May to 4%. That's the lowest in 2 years. But that's still double the Fed's 2% target.
I think if you look at core PCE inflation overall, look at it over the last 6 months, you're just not seeing a lot of progress. It's running, and it's running at a level of, you know, over 4.5%, far above our target, and not really, you know, moving down. We want to see it moving down decisively. That's all. We are going to get inflation down to 2% over time. We want to do that with the minimum damage we can to the economy, of course, but we have to get inflation down to 2%, and we will. And we just don't see that yet.
Wednesday's decision to keep rates unchanged snapped a string of 10 consecutive hikes. It left the Fed's key borrowing rate in a target range of 5 to 5.25%.